it comes to healthy diet, my first comment will be that there is no such thing as an anti-inflammatory diet. There is no diet that has been studied that shows that food alone will decrease activity of lupus. You will not be able to treat your disease with diet alone. You will not be able to treat your disease with supplements alone. Taking supplements, nutritional or herbal extracts, may have unpredictable consequences, because some of them can be immune boosters and can make the disease itself much worse. We've had patients who took herbal extracts and had severe disease activity, only to go into complete remission once they stopped them. So we always tell patients to avoid these herbal extracts because none of them have been shown to help lupus, at least not in any randomized or clinically controlled trials. Since the cardiovascular risk is high, the recommendations for all lupus patients are the same as for patients who have a high cardiovascular risk. So having a Mediterranean diet with a lot of vegetables, fruit, moderate intake of poultry and non-red meat, and keeping an eye on your weight and calorie intake. So exercise is going to decrease their long-term cardiovascular risk. Exercise will maintain their muscle mass if they're on corticosteroids. Corticosteroids will lead to muscle atrophy. So if they start the steroids and they're bedbound, it will take them a long time to regain their functional ability once the disease activity is improved. So exercise is essential. It's also essential for patients who have fibromyalgia, since there is no treatment that has been shown to be better than exercise alone, things like Tai Chi, which have been studied in the past. There are a few things that all patients with lupus need to know. So they need to know that they're a higher risk of infection. The risk of infection is there with the disease alone, but it can be increased by the medications they take. So getting vaccinated on time, getting your flu shot is very important. Having an autoimmune disease like lupus impedes your ability to fight encapsulated bacteria like pneumococcus. So we generally advise that all lupus patients, whether they're immunosuppressed or not, get a pneumonia vaccine. The second thing we tell everybody is that there is a slightly higher risk of malignancy. This doesn't mean that the risk is 100%. It means that it's slightly higher than the general population. There is research that shows that patients with lupus, even though they have the higher risk of malignancy, are screened less than healthy people. There's different interpretations as to why this happens. They all have complex disease. They're on medications that primary doctors may not be familiar with. Doctors have limited amount of time when they see them in the outpatient setting. So I always tell patients that they need to keep a track on that. So they need to keep up to date with their pap smears, mammography, colonoscopy, and whatever age-appropriate cancer screening they need.